Cray's emphatic and long-awaited success in the Forests of Scotland in the last round, it was back to high-speed tarmac for round five, starting and finishing in Belfast. McRae has won the Ulster Rally twice before, but Mark Lovell's victory last year was his best ever championship performance. Malcolm Wilson in the Vauxhall Astra GTE, likely to be one of the biggest threats to Ford. The biggest threat to Louise Aitken Walker in the Peugeot was carrying the BBC onboard camera for the first time. Penti Auricola in the Mitsubishi Styrian knows all about the kind of embarrassment that can lead to. Last time the championship was in Ireland, this was Penti's moment of indiscretion.
Yes, it cost us £75 for the new gate. I hear that this year all the gates are open, so we should be all right. We own forest, you can shortcut a bit of corners and brake very late and compensate with that sort of power. But in tarmac, you can't do that, because nowadays you have to drive like Alain Prost or Senna, but you're very precise and not sideways, because if you go sideways, you lose the grip of the tires and they overheat, and so that's not the way to do it.
Admire first of all the precise style of the reigning Open champion Jimmy McRae on the opening spectator stage at Nutt's Corner. Mark Lovell fastest here, but he and all the drivers agree that this kind of stage has very little to do with the fundamentals of the sport, but it's often useful as a pipe-opening warm-up for a longer event. Callie Grundle, extensive testing in Ireland had led to much revised suspension settings for the Peugeot 309 GTI. Malcolm Wilson, Vauxhall Astra GTE, and remember what Penti was saying about the need to be precise and avoid sideways driving? Here's what he means. Louise Aitken Walker contrasting that with a neat, tight line in the Peugeot 205. And one of the two work Skodas, this is John Hoagland. Sadly, no David Llewellyn after the decision of Audi Sport to withdraw from British rallying. First on the road, as the rally proper entered the lanes of Ulster, Jimmy McRae. The inevitable rain had made conditions very tricky, but Mark Lovell here was able to equal the times of McRae. Fastest of all, though, Phil Collins, a man with a renowned tarmac reputation. Penti Auricola lying fourth in his Mitsubishi Styrian, uncertain braking was his main concern. Similar problems were giving Malcolm Wilson the occasional early fright in the Vauxhall Astra GTE. The front-wheel drive contest looked interesting not only with the Astras, but also with Simon Davison, who's always strongly competitive in his VW Golf GTI. Dave Metcalf, Vauxhall Astra GTE. Other front-wheel drive contenders, Callie Grundle and his Peugeot teammates, Louise Aitken Walker and Ellen Morgan.
30, flat right over brow into medium left. Callie's off. Flat right and easy right. Flat left. 30. Slight right into long, long slight left.
Midstage, and Ellen Morgan has pointed out Callie Grundle's Peugeot 309 half in a ditch. Louise and Ellen complete the stage. Back on the road, Grundle's challenge is rapidly disappearing.
Easy left to stop. That was slippy. See, Callie? Nothing you can do.
Louise wonders whether there was any assistance they could have given. A couple of spectators had already provided the push that the Swede needed to get back on the stage. He'd rejoined just ahead of John Hoagland's Skoda, but now it was straight to service to assess the damage. At first sight, the damage appears only superficial, a couple of crumpled panels, but the damage to his effort on the Ulster is very significant. Grundle's mistake costing him over 4 minutes.
We just hit the most K came in very honestly, so I have to take the handbrake and save the car in the last minute. We were standing nearly on the road, but no chance to come up ourselves. So one person, he came and helped us. Then we were up on the road again.
It was very unfortunate because his car was tilted and the front wheels were nearly off the ground, so he couldn't, the front wheel drive, he could hardly get it back on the road. But come round the corner and you're a bit committed, and then there could be muck in the road and you just slide all over the place. You can't do anything about it. You've just got to steer the car as best as possible.
And medium right.
At the front of the field, Jimmy McRae, with Rob Arthur alongside him, was now beginning to show his authority. A couple of fastest times helped him pull out a 20-second lead on the rest of the field. The rest of the field, that is, apart from Lovell, whose attacking driving kept him within a few seconds. This is yump country. High-speed jumps that can look spectacular, but can easily put you out of the event. So, one of the rare moments of extra caution for Lovell, but a terrific duel between the two was starting to develop. With six stages gone, there was only a few seconds between McRae and Lovell. Phil Collins was trying equally hard, but had dropped almost 30 seconds further back in third. Fourth place, championship leader Penti Auricola. Fifth, another solid-looking drive developing from Malcolm Wilson in the Astra GTE, and he, like Auricola and McRae, is a driver still with a definite chance of the overall title. Sixth place, the right-hand drive Astra of Dave Metcalf, about 15 seconds behind. And as ever, taking the battle to the fellas in no uncertain fashion, Louise Aitken Walker and Ellen Morgan in their Peugeot.
Absolute brow 30, we jump 30, turn hard 90 right. 30, 30, left over brow 50. Quick left and long easy right. Quick right, 30, flat left, 30, jump, 30. Quick right over brow and jump, 50. Long flat right, wee bumps, 30. Quick right, maybe. 50, quick left over brow, 30.
But at this point, the first dramatic development on that leaderboard as Penti Auricola attacks a yump, lands heavily. The car seems undamaged, but Penti has painfully ricked his back and he wouldn't be able to continue. Behind the slowing Mitsubishi on the stage are Louise and Ellen.
30. Easy left over brow, 100 to stop. Okay, Penti must have a problem, huh?
Penti pays the painful price of the Ulster yumps. It won't deter others, though. That was Simon Davison taking a big risk with his seventh position, but top prize for distance, style and resultant damage goes to Vince Whetton. All will surely be put right at service at the end of a day that saw McRae leading Lovell by just a single second. For McRae, most attention at service was being paid to brakes.
As soon as they get too hot, they get too quickly.
Lovell was similarly preoccupied, all a symptom perhaps of the increasing power of these cars.
No, I think the Group A cars have got a bit quicker now. Since last year, we were looking at the times over some of the stages and they're a bit quicker. And you know, the cars have got quicker and the brakes are the same, so obviously they're taking more of a pounding. It's going to be a different rally tomorrow. The stages out that way are a bit longer, a bit more bumpy as well, so anything can happen. It'll be a good run for sure.
We'll be right back. McRae leading into the second day, but a casualty towards the end of day one had been Louise with a broken throttle linkage. The battle at the front, however, quite compelling. Lovell always threatening to overhaul McRae, but hampered by a problem with a differential, heightened because of the slippery conditions. The third Sierra Cosworth was still that of Phil Collins, but he'd soon crash out, making it a straight fight between McRae and Lovell for victory. The front-wheel drive cars didn't seem to be especially hampered by the conditions. Malcolm Wilson kept fourth, but growing quicker and ever more confident, Dave Metcalf in fifth. Simon Davison going as hard as he could in the Golf GTI, but unable to make any great impression on Metcalf or Wilson. Leo Shaw lying seventh and leading the Group N showroom class. This is the second David Sutton prepared Golf GTI of Andrew Wood, also well placed despite this mistake, lying eighth behind Shaw and Davison. Chris Birkbeck's Astra rounding off the front-wheel drive contest, but things were about to be resolved at the front of the field. McRae, despite the need for aggression, was encountering few problems. But Lovell, plagued by the differential trouble, had gambled on slick tyres in the damp conditions in a final effort to close the gap, and the gamble hadn't paid off. The Cosworth had hit a bump with four stages left and slid into a ditch. The time lost on the stage is obvious from the proximity of Malcolm Wilson. The time spent in repairing the damage would decide the rally.
We've had diff trouble earlier on, and we were 34 seconds behind Jimmy with just these four stages to go. So we put slicks on, and as you can well see from the weather today, it was a bit of a brave move. And we were just going balls out, as they say, and we slid off into the trees on a tight right-hander. But, you know, you've got to give it a go. We're here to win, not to be second. But I think we'll be all right. We can carry on and finish second with a bit of luck.
But even that comfortable second depended on the mechanics. Wilson admittedly was over 3 minutes behind. Co-driver Terry Harriman's job, among much else, is to worry about the timings. No time left, and without doubt, Lovell was now clocking up road penalties. No time for an artistic approach from the mechanics. Lovell had to get back on the road. To McRae was now removed, safely heading to his third win on the Ulster, and along with his six wins on the circuit of Ireland, it shows his love of competition in this part of the world. Mark Lovell had made a terrific fight of it though, and the state of his car clearly demonstrated that he definitely hadn't been settling for second. Malcolm Wilson can always be relied upon for a place in the top three, and with the demise of Phil Collins, once again he'd achieve that. The Astra GTE, winner of the recent New Zealand World Championship round, increasingly impressive, emphasised by Dave Metcalf's strong drive into fourth. Next came the VW Golf GTIs, Simon Davison fifth, and Andrew Wood sixth. And a very fine seventh place by Midlander Ian Tilk in his Sierra Cosworth. One of the best drives of the rally, though, came from Callie Grundle. Last after his mistake early on, he'd forced his way into eighth by the finish. And Group N success, and therefore the Group N championship, went to Gwyndaf Evans, that after Leo Shaw had dropped out with overheating problems. But for the third time this season, the victor's champagne went to Jimmy McRae and Rob Arthur, ultimately over 5 minutes ahead of last year's winner Mark Lovell. The result of a rally that saw 61 starters, 34 finishers, and absent from that finishing order, the all-important name of Penti Auricola. Which means that Jimmy McRae takes over at the head of the championship, 9 points clear of Auricola, 15 clear of Wilson. All three have a chance of the title in yet another final round showdown on the Isle of Man. But the best chance of all lies with a driver in form, Jimmy McRae. And we'll have